Hey Antidot, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is your babe Antoinette. If this is your first time here, thank you so much for stopping by. And now that you're here, kindly join us. We want you in here. I mean right in here. We love you, we appreciate you. We don't know you yet, but we want to know you. We want to get to know you. If you're the oldie and goodie, thank you so much. You guys are the real MVP. I appreciate each and every one of you. Okay, so today we are talking about wedding expectations versus realities. I have a video about marriage expectations versus reality, and I will put it up here and also in the description box. So if you haven't watched it, you guys can go and watch it. But that one is for marriage, like years after the wedding. This particular one is for the wedding. Now for the ring. For the ring, she go do anything for the ring. Now for the wedding, she be up on my bed till 7. So this is actually like a story time, but I don't just want to like give a story. I want to see how best I can help someone out there, because after the pandemic, lots of weddings, okay, lots of weddings after this pandemic, people were about to get wedded before this thing. So I know after all of this, we are going to be invited to a lot of weddings. So I know this will be helpful to someone out there. So the first thing that we normally expect is that our family members and our friends will give us their all for our wedding. When I say their all, we expect that they will give us their time, their energy, and their finances. Mm-hmm. That is what we expect, but that is not always the case. For some people, they make it a choice not to give you. But when you think about the way the world is moving, you know that most people don't give because they don't have, or they have other important things to attend to. They have other important places to be, so they don't give you their time. They have other important things to spend their money on, so they don't give you what you expect them to give you. So what I'll advise is plan your wedding yourself and put what you can afford into your wedding before experiencing the worst embarrassment ever. For me, I am still grateful to my husband because he was the one that said, I know this and this and this have promised you this, but see, we are not going to wait for them. If they end up giving us, they will just save it for something else. But let's plan our wedding how we are able to, like basically what we can afford, what he can afford then, because I wasn't working. So that is how it happened. We just did what we could afford. Make it small but classy, make it small but sweet. Don't go and invite 1,000 people because you think your uncle will be giving you 5 bags of rice, your auntie will be renting the hall, your uncle, other uncle will be paying for the drinks. Do what you can afford. If you can afford to feed 100 people, prepare for 100 people and don't go above that, because you want everyone at your wedding to eat well and drink well and feel good. The second thing is venue. Venue, guys. Me personally, that's why I said this is going to be like a story time, but people are going to learn a few things from it. Everybody that knows me, they know I always wanted a green wedding. I just loved green weddings. I love outdoor weddings. It's not like I don't want to get married in a church, but I always wanted the religious person, the pastor or whatnot, to go to the venue and just pray for the wedding and all of that. You know what I mean? Where 2 or 3 are gathered, God is there. So that is what I wanted, because I just love to say my vows with the greens. That is just my kind of vibe. I always loved it and I always wanted a green wedding. However, it didn't happen. Okay, we went to golf club. I think that is the best green scene that we have here. We went there, well, in Freetown, we went there, but then they told us, as long as you are not part of the club, the golf club, you are not allowed to do your program here. So that is how I missed having a green wedding. My wedding happened in a church. So to me, just be focused on your wedding. The venue is important, but whether you have it or not, your wedding is still going to happen anyways. And most times you don't end up having the venue that you want. Either it is booked before you, or you don't just have it. That is the reality. The next thing for me is music playlist. Bobby and I, we have the same taste for music. We love the same kinds of songs and all of that. So before the wedding, we were like, oh, let's just sit down and arrange our playlist. We sat down, We arranged, in fact, he arranged the playlist, and up to this moment, that playlist is in his computer. We didn't touch it at all, at all, at all. We didn't. Like, on the wedding day, on that day, all you are focused on is reading your vows, and that's just it. So we chose sentimental, and we love Gumbe songs. We love oldies, country music, oldies. Those are our music. Like, we are just old people like that, but those are the kinds of music that we love. Oldies, sentimental, Gumbe songs, and a splash of R&B, a touch of R&B. So we placed all of those in a playlist, but it never worked. On the wedding day, at the reception, the DJs were just playing what they wanted to play. The only thing that we controlled was the fact that when we are entering into the hall, we played Gumbe, because we actually hired the Gumbe guys to beat for us. Yes. And then we controlled the first dance. Like, we danced to Don Williams. He just acted smart while everything was going on. He just went to the DJ and asked him, "Do you have this Don Williams song?" And then the guy was like, "Yes." So he asked him to play it. That was how lucky we were. But all other songs were not ours. Okay? They played any and every kind. Just, we didn't even bother. Like, it's just after the wedding that we started saying, "And why were they playing that?" But the day is gone. Another thing that we stress about, well, children of nowadays, is guest book. Wedding guest book. Two things can happen. One, it is possible that you'll get your guest to sign your guest book, but you will misplace it, or you will not even open it after the wedding. The second thing is what happened to me. Nobody signed my guest book because it went late. Mm-hmm. Because the guest book is supposed to be there in the church before the guests arrive. So as they are coming in, they'll just sign. That was not my case. The guest book went there after the people were seated. And up to this moment, I hold it there. I have sentimental attachments to my guest book. I have sentimental attachments to my guest book. So this is my guest book. Let me open the first page so you guys can see. Have you seen that? As empty as, I don't know. Nobody signed it. It went late. Okay, we were so stuck in traffic, we couldn't get there early. And I regretted the fact that I didn't give it to Hobby, because obviously he's the one that gets into the church first. So I don't know, but nobody signed it. I was like, my guest book, everybody is going to sign and make a wish. This is it, as blank as ever. And this is where the pen stood. Like, the pen was here. You know what I'm saying? The pen was here like that. And then it was just standing close to the book. It was supposed to be like this. The book is standing there with this sign. It's still in its packet, like, with this, "Please sign our guest book." So it was supposed to be there all cute on the table. As people come in, they sign before they get their seat. Just chic like that. That is how we planned it. Like, I'm a Pinterest girl. I work online. Everything I do, everything about me, I search online. Google, YouTube, Pinterest. So I had lots of ideas. Most of them didn't work. That is to tell you, don't stress the small stuff. Try to arrange things that are necessary, period. So this is it. My guest book is here. If you want it, let me know. I didn't get to use it. Okay. Another thing we expect is, on our wedding day, we will dance our feet off. Like, wagushire. Hey, that is my day, my one and only day. Wagudon dance done. I did dance a butu at Naple, all my feel saying I'm a wedding. Well, few people get the opportunity to do that, but it depends on if you have not been walking before your wedding, you can dance because there is the energy. But for us, we were wholly and solely our own wedding planners. So on that day, we were so tired. The only time that we really danced was the Gumbe, because no boy look, no people they shame. So we really danced to the Gumbe while we were entering the hall. But after that, man, dancing was just out of it. After the first dance to come in, it was just, okay, I've done it. I've done it. That first one, first impression goes a long way. I've done it. Any other thing is just zero. So when we danced to open the floor, the first dance, the first couple dance to Don Williams' song, I was just so grateful that that song is slow. Nobody will tell me you didn't dance. The song is slow. So we are just rocking like Desperately loving you, desperately. You know how it goes. No yagba, no stress. We just did cool things, so you won't have the energy to dance as much as you want. Also, most times we expect that when we make our wedding souvenir, people are going to appreciate it. People are going to accept them with all, like, they are going to understand this is the use of it and they are going to appreciate it. For people in the abroad, most times they appreciate souvenir, but here, as long as it's not something to eat, they hardly appreciate it. It's just people that know the value of those little things that appreciate what you made for souvenir. Most of the people that attend your wedding are just going to leave them behind. We made a disc with all our childhood pictures, most of our childhood pictures. We made them into disc CD plates or DVD plates, and then we placed them on the tables. Sadly, a lot of people left them there. A lot of people left them lying there. The only souvenir that they were glad to receive was the chin chin. That was just it. So as long as it's not food, only a few people will appreciate it. Another thing that we expect for our wedding is that we are going to come home that night and get a good, a hot, a spicy wedding night. That is not the case. You leave your wedding reception hall very late and tired. When you come home, you're just going to sleep. That is what happened in our case. But most times we think, on my wedding night, kondo go iti mama. Hey, wa go don come on first na the reception. Wa go draw hobby. I will just grab hobby by the tie. It's a lie. At night, after your wedding reception and party, when you come home, what you're going to do is sleep. Okay? That is the reality. You're going to sleep after the reception. You are not going to have the energy to perform your first marital duty. You're just going to sleep. You're not going to have all that energy that you are thinking. You're just going to sleep straight off to bed. In fact, we left my wedding reception hall, I think, about 3 a.m. So just imagine how tired I was. We just came home and then we slept our tiredness off and woke up the next morning to go to church. So when you think it's 3 a.m. already and in the morning I'll be going to church, you're just going to sleep. Don't stress yourself about the small stuff. Weddings are for people to go to church, sign, go to the reception, eat and party. That is all people are about. That is what they care about. So all the other things, they don't really matter to them. In fact, here a lot of people don't even go to church. All they care about is go to party, eat and go back home. So all the other things don't really matter. That is it for today's video. That is my experience. I want to hear yours, and thank you so much for watching. Please make sure you like this video, comment, subscribe and share. You might be helping someone to focus on what is important. Go to church, go to mosque or wherever your program is being held. Sign that register. Make good food for people. Cater for drinks. Enough drinks for people. Do your wedding. Smile through the process and go home and sleep. That is it. The next day you can enter the Shukublai. Thank you guys. Bye.